Glenn Goorjian would take over as coach of the Australian national team in 2001 following the brief tenure of Phil Smyth, who coached Australia to their first ever loss to New Zealand in the Oceania Championships that year. Goorjian was an accomplished coach in the NBL. He played for Lyndsay Gaze on the Melbourne Tigers between 77 and 85 before turning to coaching. As coach of the Eastside Spectres, in 1991, his fourth year with the team, he guided them to the finals where they lost to the Perth Wildcats.
With the battle for the corporate dollar so intense, sporting clubs face as tough a challenge off the field as they do on it. Whether it be Aussie rules, rugby league or basketball, the battle to survive as a viable business is paramount.
The team merged with the Melbourne Saints to become the South East Melbourne Magic.
The word merger sends shudders through many an administrator and fan. So when the Eastside Spectres and the Southern Melbourne Saints merged early in 1992, their progress would be keenly watched by many. Was it a risk? Would they fail? Could two teams with great tradition be able to blend successfully?
In 1992 and 1996, Goorjian won the national championship, defeating Lyndsay Gaze's Melbourne Tigers both times.
Well, it's history now. The South East Melbourne Magic did more than just survive. In their inaugural year, they turned the basketball world upside down, winning the 1992 title.
In 1998, the Magic merged with the North Melbourne Giants to become the Victoria Titans. Goorjian remained on as head coach, helping the Titans reach the grand finals in 99 and 2000, but when the team was sold in 2002, the new owners fired Goorjian. He would sign in the NBL with the Sydney Kings alongside his appointment as head coach of the Boomers. He inherited a national team that were transitioning from the previous era led by Gaze into a younger squad that would need to build their chemistry and prove themselves on the national stage. The Boomers' first major tournament following this transition was the 2004 Athens Olympics. The team failed to make it out of the group stage, but a young Andrew Bogut would catch the attention of the basketball world with a string of impressive performances. Bogut was born in Melbourne in 1984. His parents had emigrated from Croatia, and while he was growing up and learning to play basketball, he styled himself after Tony Kukoc. Bogut moved to America in 2003 to play college basketball for the Utes.
On a hippie trailhead full of zombies, I met a strange lady. She made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. And she said, do you come from a land down under? Where women glow and men blunder. Can't you hear the thunder? You better run, you better take cover.
He earned the John Wooden Award for Most Outstanding National College Basketball Player in 2005 before entering the NBA draft, where he was drafted first overall by the Milwaukee Bucks. He would play again for the Boomers at the 2006 FIBA World Championships in Japan.
Coming up, it's the dream matchup for the Boomers, Australia against the number one ranked United States of America. The Australian team won two of their five pool matches and have progressed through to the round of 16. The winner here through to the quarterfinals. And the United States of America, what a lineup this is, Steve.
Oh my goodness, just looking at that thing. Chris Paul's been outstanding. He's really shown his quickness and his ability to find his teammates. LeBron James, Carmelo Anthony, Elton Brand's been a monster down there.
The United States against Australia at the Olympic or World Championship level, will they lead the head-to-head 11-0? But having said that, three times during those 11 matches, Australia has been within 10 points or less. It was only 2 points at the World Championships in 1978 in the Philippines, just 1 point at the 1990 World Championships in Argentina, and the most recent meeting between these teams was at the Olympic Games in 2004, and it was 89-79 to the United States. Only a 10-point ball game, and with one quarter to play, it is the USA with a commanding 39-point lead. At three-quarter time, exclusive to Fox Sports, it's America 88, Australia 49 here on Fox Sports. Well, this hasn't been Australia's best performance that we've seen at the World Championships. They were going to need their best to be competitive against the might of the number one team in the world. They just haven't been able to put it together in their final match of the campaign.
That'll be about it.
Well, it's been a very impressive display by the number one seeds in the World Championship favourites, the USA. They've defeated the Boomers by 40 points full time. USA 113, Australia 73.
Hustle up!
Guys, we've got to put some points on the board. We're down big.
Put Andy in.
We got to get Andy the ball.
We're getting killed on the boards, too.
Coach, Andy's our best rebounder.
We need Andy.
Andrew.
For the 2008 Beijing Olympics, more talented young players would join the Boomers. The tournament was the first major competition for Joe Ingles and Patty Mills. Ingles had begun his playing career in Melbourne for the Southern Dragons in 2006.
Ingles from downtown, he fills it up. My word, he is a very, very cool customer for a kid of pace.
His debut was one of the most impressive in NBL history and propelled him on to win Rookie of the Year.
Hip, hip. Hooray. How's it feel to be 15?
Nervous before the game. Really, before the New Zealand, went to the toilet about eight times, I reckon.
He's 6'8" and still growing, but unsure where he gets his height.
My mum's really short, and dad's, I think, just 6 foot, so everyone says a milkman, but...
Well, the South Dragons may have lost their opening two games of the NBL season, but they've also uncovered one of the finds of the competition. Teenage rookie Joe Ingles starred on debut. Now he dreams of an NBA career.
What are your dreams, mate? Are you going NBA?
Obviously, yeah, it's my ultimate dream.
He's arrived, all right, this kid. Signing for life, the South Dragons. That's if you can keep him. But more about this. What a night for an introduction.
Buying bread from a man in Brussels. He was 6'4" and full of muscle. I said, do you speak my language? He just smiled and gave me a Vegemite sandwich. And he said, I come from a land, land, land.
The Boomers were once again matched up against the USA in the 2008 Beijing Olympics in the quarterfinals and lost in a blowout. Patty Mills' impressive play for the junior national team helped him earn a scholarship to St. Mary's College of California in 2007.
It's always going to be hard, I think, for someone to truly describe the feeling of what it feels like to put on the green and gold. You can try as much as you like, but at the end of the day, I don't think you really be able to pass on, you know, that feeling of running out, having your name called out, singing the national anthem. You know, they're all goosebump feelings.
Patty Mills was drafted into the NBA by the Portland Trail Blazers and showed promise in his second season after an injury-ridden rookie campaign.
Pat Stacks, don't forget the name, Kamanacha.
During the NBA lockout, he would briefly sign in the NBL before receiving a big contract offer to play in China. Upon his return to America, he was waived by the Blazers and signed by San Antonio.
It smells great, fellas. What's cooking?
He would fit in well with a Spurs roster that was laden with international talent.
Sounds great. Can I have some?
Sure. So we should...
I don't know. Share?
Come on, man. You know what we want.
Toss another burger on the barbie?
Yes! I love his accent.
Now, you're from Happy Valley, South Australia. Is everyone very happy there?
They definitely are. And we just got a 24-hour McDonald's, so it makes Happy Valley a bit bigger and a bit more up there.
Even how many people live there?
I have no idea. It's
a couple hundred?
Yeah, 15, 16.
In 2009, Joe Ingles helped the Southern Dragons win their first ever NBL championship. He would move to Europe after this as the team folded due to financial difficulties. He would play for Granada for one season before moving to Barcelona.
And that...
Oh, his arm's out.
Ugly. Oh, my goodness.
His right elbow.
That was horrific.
I break my elbow and can't extend my arm for 4 months. And there's always question marks whether it's going to be the same again.
Andrew Bogut didn't play for the Boomers in the 2010 World Championships and was also set to miss the 2012 London Olympics following another injury.
Well, bad news for Milwaukee as Andrew Bogut had to limp off to the locker room.
There was hope that Kyrie Irving, the first overall pick in the 2011 NBA draft and a dual Australian-American citizen, would choose to represent the Boomers.
G'day, mate. That's it.
The go-to line.
Yeah.
G'day. Do you know anything about the Australian National Anthem? Can you... Australians all let us rejoice?
I know nothing about it.
You don't know anything about it? Nah, damn. I was going to get you to sing the Australian National Anthem.
I don't know it.
He would ultimately choose the United States. He wouldn't make the cut for the 2012 team, who would once again knock Australia out of the competition.
Having the chance to represent Australia at that world stage, at a World Cup, is obviously great. There's another level of fire that is ignited when I have that opportunity. But, you know, in talking about individual performances, I've always had a different role on the national team that I might have had here in San Antonio, and making the most of that opportunity to go back and play is obviously great fun. For me, I guess the challenge that I've got to find is being able to see how I can transition that into my role here in San Antonio.
The Australian women's team, known as the Opals, had achieved considerably more success than the men's side since the early 90s. They earned the bronze medal in 2012, a backward step after finishing the previous three Olympic Games with the silver medal. This year was the first appearance of Liz Cambage, who became the first woman to dunk during Olympic play. Cambage had been drafted by Tulsa in the WNBA draft, but wasn't enamoured with the idea of moving to the state of Oklahoma.
Rising Australian basketball star Liz Cambage has packed her bags and flown out of Melbourne to begin her new life in the American big time. The teenage sensation was snapped up at pick two by the Tulsa Shock in last month's women's NBA draft.
Like when we were driving over the Balti, I was like, bye, my beautiful city, and the sun was coming up and it was so depressing.
I don't want to play at Tulsa, I've made that clear. They want to make me a franchise player, but I'm not going to the WNBA for that. I'm going there to learn and improve my game. But what can you do?
Patty Mills' role with the Spurs would grow over his first few seasons in San Antonio. He became one of the league's best instant offense options coming off the bench. The Spurs made the NBA Finals in consecutive years in 2013 and 2014, winning the Larry O'Brien Trophy on their second attempt.
Larry O'Brien! Get up, boys. Yeah, get off.
In 2013, Joe Ingles left Barcelona to join Maccabi Tel Aviv. In his only season with the club, he helped them win the EuroLeague, defeating Real Madrid in overtime of the final.
Mills and Ingles play on opposite sides of the globe, but share the same passion for their national team.
I think if we can keep that young core group together that we've got for the next, for definitely Rio and maybe further than that, we've got a really bright future.
Now, it's one thing to put on the green and gold, but to do it with your best friends, you know, it makes it that much more fun to come back and be involved.
Bogut and Mills would sit out the 2014 World Championships, but the emergence of Matthew Dellavedova and Aaron Baines helped the Boomers remain competitive. They were accused of deliberately tanking their final group game against Angola to gain a more favourable matchup in the knockout round. The tactic backfired though, as Turkey would defeat them 65-64 in the round of 16. After battling back from injury, Andrew Bogut found himself on the West Coast with the Golden State Warriors after the Bucks traded him.
One of the storylines for the Warriors this season has definitely been, when will Andrew Bogut return to the court?
You know, the guy who maybe had the least amount of impact as showing me the way of life in the NBA, but showed me one of the most important things he could ever teach me was Andrew Bogut. You know, he showed me how to guard the post. I'll never forget it. My first day out of Golden State, he was teaching me different things you could do that you couldn't do in college. Mm-hmm. And throughout the course of that year, just teaching me positioning and stuff. Like, I wouldn't be half the defender I am without Andrew Bogut. And, like, he taught me so much about defense that, you know, I owe all my success to him defensively.
Bogut going up large!
I've had two potentially career-ending injuries, and I battled back from both of them, so I'm pretty proud of that.
So 1, 2, 3, take my hand and come with me because you look so fine that I really want to make you mine.
His defensive prowess and veteran leadership was central to them winning the franchise's first championship in 40 years in 2015. The Warriors returned to the finals the following year after winning a league record 73 regular season games, but would blow a 3-1 lead, losing to the Cavaliers, who featured an Australian of their own in Matthew Dellavedova. In Game 6, he combined with teammate LeBron James to score 44 points from the field.
Dellavedova! 4, 5, 6, come on and get your kicks. Now you don't need the money when you look like that, do you, honey?
At that summer's NBA draft, an Australian was taken with the first overall pick once again as Ben Simmons joined the process in Philadelphia.
With the first pick in the 2016 NBA draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select Ben Simmons from Melbourne, Australia, and Louisiana State University.
Simmons' dad, Dave, had a 12-year career in the NBL after moving to Australia in the late 80s.
Ben Simmons from Australia. At various points in his career, he's been compared in terms of skills to a LeBron James type of player. You see Johnny Jones, his coach for 1 year at LSU, and that Sixers hat now goes on to Simmons as he makes his way to greet Adam Silver.
Bad news today for the Philadelphia 76ers. The team announced that an X-ray and MRI revealed that the number one overall pick in the draft, Ben Simmons, has a fracture of the fifth metatarsal bone in his right foot. The injury occurred when the rookie forward rolled his ankle during the final scrimmage of the team's 2016 training camp at Stockton University on Friday.
Simmons wouldn't compete in the 2016 Olympics in Rio de Janeiro, but the Boomers sent a strong squad that had expectations of competing for a spot on the podium. After advancing past the group stage, they defeated Lithuania to advance to the semi-finals, where they would fall to Serbia. This set up the first opportunity at the bronze medal for Australia since Andrew Gaze's squad at the 2000 Sydney Olympics. The Boomers were confident heading into the contest against Spain and hoped to earn their first medal in a major tournament.
Well, I can say, you are with me, but you are with me. I said, are you gonna be my girl? Well, it's 1, 2, 3, take my hand and come with me because you look so fine that I really wanna make you mine. I said, you look so fine that I really wanna make you mine. 4, 5, 6, come on and get your kicks. Now you don't need money with a face like that, do you?
The game was closely contested throughout, and a bad call sent Spain to the free throw line in the game's final seconds. Australia lost the game by a single point, 89-88.
Yeah, we're obviously all gutted. all the boys knowing how much, I guess, hard work and dedication to be able to achieve something that we all desperately wanted, and it's a tough feeling. When you have the honour to be able to put on these colours and play for your whole country, you know, it's bigger than sport. It comes down to a whole lot of pride and passion, and obviously unfortunate, unlucky, but it's exciting times, and you know, you just hope that this following of our team and of basketball within Australia, along with the girls, continues to grow even more.
The heartbreaking defeat meant waiting another 3 years for the next major tournament. The country was hopeful that the addition of Ben Simmons would give them the boost they needed to earn a spot on the podium.
Is your aim to be the best player in the world?
For sure.
What do you think it'll take to get there?
It's hard work, and time.
And, I mean, is the dream LeBron? Is it, I think, Michael Jordan? Do we see him as untouchable?
It's Ben Simmons. You know, I want to be the best player I can be.
How far can Ben Simmons go?
Well, he's got to get a jump shot. it's like, it sounds humorous and all that, but I'm dead ass serious. Yeah. You can't, like, you know, because if not, he'll regret it. When his career is over, and you look at what he's doing now without that, is astonishing. Now imagine you can shoot the ball. What does that open up for you? You don't want to retire. No, seriously, you don't want to retire and look back and go, man, if I just had a jump shot, what would I have done? You don't want that. You don't want that. So I don't care if you have to lock yourself in a gym 10 hours a day. If this kid gets a jump shot, it's a serious, serious problem. A serious, serious problem.
Again on the attack. Six to shoot. One-on-one defense by Kyle Anderson forces a fadeaway air ball.
I said, are you gonna be my girl?
Simmons surveying out front. LeBron laying all the way back in the key. Daring him to shoot, Simmons does. And now the Lakers will get the last shot.
One more time.
Boy, LeBron James wasn't even close to Simmons, the guy that he mentored.
Ben Simmons took a three, and you could hear the fans kind of rise up. It's such a rare occurrence, just his third three-point attempt this year. And just rimmed out.
The NBA's contingent from the land down under was growing larger each year. Thon Maker was also drafted in the lottery in the Ben Simmons draft. Joe Ingles was signed by the Utah Jazz in 2014. Liz Cambage returned to the WNBA to play for the Dallas Wings after spending 4 years playing in China. Aaron Baines and Dellavedova were already established in the league, and expectations were still high for the fifth pick of the 2014 draft, Dante Exum.
Hello, reservation for two at 9:30. Dante Exum? Exum. E-X. Yes, X. Like Xenopus. It's a genus of frogs.
Members of the national men's basketball team have arrived back in Australia this morning following their spectacular brawl in the Philippines with players and staff from the home team.
I do believe that their coach, Chet Reyes, incited them to come out and thug us. I think there's evidence of that, video evidence of that. Then he substituted a thug out there who took three or four cheap swings at Bubbles. This is out of the party line, but I'm most disturbed with their head coach.
The 2019 FIBA World Cup was on the distant horizon, and this time around, they would have to qualify via the FIBA Asia Cup, which they did with ease, winning all six of their games by double digits.
Ben Simmons
Simmons said he is pulling out of the FIBA World Cup, and the reason why has his fans in Australia livid, because they feel like he's abandoning his own country in favor of the Sixers. They went off on Twitter, shading Ben for backing out of the World Cup, and Sixers reporter Brian Michael Jacobs believes that he's hanging back in the States to work on his shot.
Hey, Cameron, Ben, you went to LSU. Man up, man. Man up. Stop messing around. Come on now. You know better than that.